And there's actually only a single decidable property here. All of the other properties are undecidable. Now let's go quickly through them one by one to discuss why that is. So always returns one, you know that is undecidable by Rice theorem. It's a similar case here, we already had that. Adding two numbers, Rice theorem, doesn't do anything. Rice theorem, no matter how you define, doesn't do anything. It will always come back to Rice theorem. Converts an MP3 file, Rice theorem. Reads a file, that is an interesting one because you could argue that this does not fall under Rice theorem, but even if you have that argument, it's still not decidable because what I could do, for example, so I can modify any program so that it only will read a file once it's done. And that again would allow me to solve the halting problem. Is a program a virus? Rice theorem. Writes to a file, similar logic as reads to a file. Modifies itself. That is an interesting one. Because of course here you could again say, well, of course, I can just go through the code and whenever the program accesses itself, I know it has that property. But the thing is this, the program could have certain lines that suggest this program modifies itself, but deciding whether those lines will actually be reached once the program executes, that again would allow you to solve the halting problem. So also this isn't decidable. The same one here. Of course you can look at a certain program and say, does this program return integers. But if you had a program that can decide if another program only returns integers, that would again allow you to solve the halting problem. And the same thing for downloading data. If I had a program that designs generally for any other program if it downloads data, I could use the same technique as for reading a file. I could basically modify any program so that it will run completely on its own data that it already has included and downloads data basically to signify that it's done. If I could decide this in the general case, then I would also have solved the halting problem. Now the question of course is if this here has any practical relevance. For example, reading a file. Because for most programs, of course, you will be able to decide if they ever read a file or not. Then again, on the other hand, if you look at general software testing, this is an interesting question from a perspective of code coverage, for example. If you could decide if a program reads a file, and of course you want the program to read a file, then that would tell you something about the correctness of that program.